Ho, 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 ho. Velkommen tilbage. Welcome back. Det er den 1. december. It's December 1st. Og det er fantastisk. Nå, today we are doing some phrases, intermediate phrases, as you can see, part one. It's not the only one. So, without further ado, let's begin. Oh, a quick reminder. Check the website. It's awesome. All right, let's begin. Jeg er nødt til at gøre det. Jeg er nødt til at gøre det. I need to do it. Or like, I have to do it. Right? Jeg er nødt til at gøre det. Jeg har ikke noget valg. Jeg har ikke noget valg. Or valg, but nobody really pronounces that G. I don't have a choice. Jeg har ikke noget valg. Det er ikke op til mig. Det er ikke op til mig. It's not up to me. Nej, it ain't. Det er ikke op til mig. Jeg overvejer at gøre det. Jeg overvejer at gøre det. I'm considering doing it or thinking about, right? Overvejer at gøre det. Alright. Synes du, jeg skal gøre det? Synes du, jeg skal gøre det? Do you think I should do it? Synes du, jeg skal gøre det? Altså, hvis jeg var dig, ville jeg... Hvis jeg var dig, ville jeg. And then whatever, right? There's an version here with ville. So, if I were you, I would. Whatever the action is, just put something in infinitive. Hvis jeg var dig, ville jeg. Something, something. Alright. Jeg foreslår, at du. I suggest... That you, again, some action, but in present tense, right? It's important. Jeg foreslår, at du spiser, sover, gør det, husker something, something, any verb. Jeg foreslår, at du... Alright. Det er værd at overveje. Det er værd at overveje. It's worth considering. Det er værd at overveje. Du behøver ikke gøre det. Og du behøver ikke at gøre det. The at is optional. Du behøver ikke gøre det. You don't have to do it. Right. In Danish we have many words for have to or need to. This is just one. Behøver. Right. Du behøver ikke gøre det. Nej, nej, nej. Har du taget en beslutning? Har du taget en beslutning? Have you made a decision? Har du taget en beslutning? Yeah, that's how it is. Jeg har besluttet at. Jeg har besluttet at. I've decided that or to. Because it can be both a verb or a situation coming after. Right. Jeg har besluttet at. Nice. Du gjorde det rigtige. Du gjorde. Du gjorde det rigtige. You did the right thing. Du gjorde det rigtige. And yeah, notice that I don't say den rigtige ting. That is unnatural. Right? Det rigtige. That is how you say it. Gjorde det rigtige. Oh yeah. Jeg er stolt af dig. Jeg er stolt af dig. I'm proud of you. Jeg er stolt af dig. Stolt. That's such a great word. Stolt. Jeg respekterer dit valg. Jeg respekterer dit valg. I respect your choice. Respekterer. That's a good one. Jeg respekterer. Jeg har gjort noget dumt. Jeg har gjort noget dumt. I've done something stupid, or I did something stupid, but literally I have done. Jeg har gjort. Jeg har gjort noget dumt. And yes, there are many, many ways in Danish of saying that you did something you shouldn't have. We'll get to that another time, more in depth. Jeg har gjort noget dumt. Det skulle jeg ikke have gjort. Det skulle jeg ikke have gjort. I shouldn't have done that. Like, this is nice. This is why I say it's intermediate, because it's a little more, it's not really advanced, but it's a little more complex than the basic stuff. It's a det skulle jeg, there's inversion. That should I not have done. Right? Det skulle jeg ikke have gjort. Yes, so we got the present perfect here. Like that. Okay. Jeg fortryder det. Jeg fortryder det. I regret it. Fortryder. Fortryder. Right? Very nice. Så har du lært det. Så har du lært det. Then you learn that. Now, this is a weird translation in English, I'm sure. But we do say this in Danish. The reason why I make this in cursive, det, I don't normally do this, but that's because we always have the stress or the emphasis, eh? Well, you learned that. Okay, you did something wrong or you made a mistake, but you learned that lesson at least. Så har du lært det. But again, my videos are not enough, so go out there, you know, if you're in Denmark, like, listen to people when they talk, you're gonna hear these things, and you're gonna get a more natural feel for how it all sounds, and it's awesome, even though it's cold. Nå. Man lærer sin fejl. Man lærer af sine fejl. You learn from your mistakes. It's the same as in English. Man lærer af sine fejl. Alright. Det er menneskeligt at fejle. Det er menneskeligt at fejle. It's human to fail. Yeah, so menneskeligt is of course the adjective, like human as, and that is a typical human thing to do. Yeah. Menneskeligt. Det er menneskeligt at fejle. Alright. Op med humøret. Op med humøret. Cheer up or chin up. Like, don't be depressed. Don't be sad. Just like, hey, it's okay. Op med humøret. Yeah, literally up with the mood. Yeah. Op med humøret. Okay. Lad os se fremad. Lad os se fremad. Lad os se fremad. Let's look forwards. Right? Fremad is like forward or forwards. Fremad. Lad os se fremad. Jeg trænger til en ferie. Jeg trænger til en ferie. Øj, jeg trænger til en ferie. Right? Need a vacation. Oop, another word for need. Trænger til. Jeg trænger til en ferie. Oof. A little pronunciation warning here. Don't say like ferie or something like that. That's gonna sound quite bad. Just say ferie and you're good. Trænger til en ferie. And then you say, hvor skal vi rejse hen? Hvor skal vi rejse hen? Hvor skal vi rejse hen? Where should we travel to? Or go. Right, so hen is sort of like to when you go into a destination. Although it's not that simple. But you'll learn that as you keep studying. It's used a lot when we're talking about going places. Hen. Hvor skal vi gå hen? Something like that. Alright. Jeg har altid drømt om at opleve... Jeg har altid drømt om at opleve. Always dreamt about experiencing something, right? So this could be whatever, you know, something you want to do, or maybe it's a castle or whatever. It's om at opleve, and then whatever it is. Yeah. Jeg har altid drømt om at opleve something, something. Alright. Har du nogensinde været i... Har du nogensinde været i... Været i... Have you ever been in or been to? And so when I say i, that usually means that it's a country. Well, country is always i, right? Or it's a city. But if it's an island, then I would say po. Right? So that's for another lesson. Well, I already covered that in i and po. You can check that out. Yeah. Now, this is assuming you're talking about a country or a city. Har du nogensinde været i... Den og det skulle være noget helt specielt. Den, det, skulle være noget helt specielt. It's supposed to be something really special. Right? So this is like when you heard about something that's rumored or it's claimed to be something special or whatever. Then you say skulle være. Right? It's like supposed to be, should be. It's very good to know. Yeah. Okay, and the reason why I have both den and det, that's because I don't know what you're talking about. Like, I don't know if you're talking about an en noun or an it noun. Right? So that depends what you're talking about. You have to be aware of the noun you're using. So yeah, of course you don't have to say den or det. You could also say the thing itself. Right? Museum or whatever. Yeah, could be a lot of things. All right. Der er så mange steder, jeg gerne vil se. Der er så mange steder, jeg gerne vil se. There are so many places I like to see. Kind of long one. Der er så mange steder, jeg gerne vil se. Awesome. Hvad glæder du dig mest til at se? Hvad glæder du dig mest til at se? What are you the most excited to see? Or what are you looking forward to the most? Right? Glæder is like, well, at glæde sig til is to look forward to something or to be excited. Yeah. And mest is of course most. Hvad glæder du dig mest til at se? Like that. Alright. Vi rejser i næste uge. Vi rejser i næste uge. We're going or traveling next week. Yeah. Vi rejser i næste uge. Right? Næste uge. Okay. Husk at købe rejseforsikring. Husk at købe rejseforsikring. Remember to buy travel insurance. Oh, I guess that's kind of boring, but oh well. Husk at købe rejseforsikring. Oh, that's a nice little R practice there. Rejseforsikring. Okay. Hvor længe skal I være der? Hvor længe skal I være der? For how long are you going to be there? I, like notice I say I and not du, because it's assuming you're traveling with someone, so I is you guys, and ustedes, like that. Oh, another touchy. So, and then it says, en uges tid, I en uges tid, for about a week. So this uges, and that's sort of a possessive, but really you can just remember that. En uges tid is like about a week, right? So maybe it's 6 days, maybe it's 8 days, but roughly a week. Yeah. En uges tid. Plejer du at få jetlag? Plejer du at få jetlag? Do you usually get jetlag? And yeah, we use the English word jetlag. We just don't have a Danish word for it. Or if we do, it's so archaic. Jetlag. Plejer du at få jet lag. Plejer is so useful because it's a verb that means usually, Right, now that might sound weird from English perspective, but that is how we do it in Danish. Plejer. Right. Yeah, det plejer jeg at få. Yeah, I usually get that. Alright, cool. Det bliver en lang flyvetur. Det bliver en lang flyvetur. It's gonna be a long flight. Flyvetur, literally like flying trip, right? Tur. Flyvetur. Mm-hmm. Jeg forberedt. Jeg forberedt. I'm prepared. Yeah, klar. Got to say, jeg klar, I'm ready. Eh? Og forberedt is like you have prepared something or prepared yourself. Jeg forberedt. All right, cool. All right, now we're shifting a little bit. Jamen, jeg blevet inviteret til fest. Jeg blevet inviteret til fest. I've been invited to a party. Jeg blevet. Oh, what is this? This is passive. Jeg blevet, og jeg blevet. Ikke både for okay. Jeg blevet inviteret, invited til fest, to a party. You don't have to say en fest. Just fest will suffice. That's enough. Yeah. Jeg blevet inviteret til fest. Det er sådan, det er. Alright. Åh, jeg elsker at møde nye mennesker. Jeg elsker at møde nye mennesker. I love meeting new people. Right? It's pretty straightforward. It just looks long, but it's really simple. Jeg elsker at møde nye mennesker. And yeah, you could also say folk, new folk. But it's just very common to say mennesker. And so the literal translation of mennesker would be humans. But we use it like you would use people in English a lot of the time. Okay. Jeg kender ikke nogen her. Jeg kender ikke nogen her. I don't know anyone here. That kind of sucks. You just look around and everybody's a stranger. Jeg kender ikke nogen. And notice that it's nogen and not know it. Like it doesn't end with a T. Because that would be something. But this is someone, right? Or anyone. Jeg kender ikke nogen her. Alright. Hvordan kender du? Hvordan kender du? How do you know? Like, how did you get to know someone? What's your story or your history? Hvordan kender du? Yeah. And then they might say, vi arbejder sammen. Vi arbejder sammen. Vi arbejder sammen. We work together. And you could also say vi kolleger og kollegaer, but this is just one way of saying it. Vi arbejder sammen. We work together. Yeah. All right. Vi mødtes til en fest. Vi mødtes til en fest. We met at a party. Yeah, again, fest. And notice that this is S. That's kind of rare in Danish, having this S when it's not passive. But we do have them. Ses is another one. And like I'm sure you heard this a million times in Denmark. Vi ses, se senere, and like see you. But yeah, mødes also has S here. Even though it's not passive or anything like that. Vi mødes til en fest. Moving on. Hvad hedder din kæreste? Hvad hedder din kæreste? What's the name of your boyfriend, girlfriend? And yeah, I know I kind of became lazy here, BFGF, but you get the meaning, eh? Kæreste covers both. It's gender neutral, you could say. Hvad hedder din kæreste? Hvad hedder din kæreste? All right. Han, hun, virker meget. Han, hun, virker meget. He or she seems very... Now, of course, this might look a little strange out of context, but imagine you're talking about someone that you don't know, but you're sort of telling people whatever your impression is. Right? So she seems very, or he seems very... Yeah. Han virker meget, hun virker meget. And then whatever adjective. Right? You can put any adjective you want. Han er lidt generet, han ikke? Han er lidt generet, han ikke? He's kind of shy, isn't he? Yeah. Er han ikke sort of an addition here at the end, because it's more natural? Han er lidt genert, er han ikke? Yeah. Genert, that's a great word. It's kind of a, I call it like the French G, because it's je sound. We have it with some words that start with G, sometimes even in the middle. Right? Genert. But it's still, it's a minority of G words. Okay. Jeg skal have en øl. Oh yeah. Jeg skal have en øl. Jeg skal have en øl. I'm getting a beer, or I gotta get a beer. Same, same. You could say either way. Right? Jeg skal have en øl. Selvfølgelig. Juleøl. Nisseøl. Because it's December. Hvad drikker du? Hvad drikker du? What are you drinking? So this could be, you see someone drinking, you're like, hey, 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 what's up, huh? What drikker du? Something like that. Den har jeg aldrig prøvet før. Den har jeg aldrig prøvet før. Never tried that before, right? Like a drink, because we're already in the context here. So den. Den har jeg aldrig prøvet før. Okay. Skal, vil du danse? Skal. Yeah, well, so that would be, I forgot, so say skal vi, eh? You cannot say skal du danse. Skal vi og vil du danse? Skal vi danse? Vil du danse? Like that. It's like, shall we dance? Do you wanna dance? Alright. Jeg bliver nødt til at gå hjem. Jeg bliver nødt til at gå hjem. I have to go home. Okay. Jeg bliver nødt til at gå hjem. Alright. Jeg har det ikke så godt. Jeg har det ikke så godt. I don't feel too well. Usually when someone says this, it's something physical. Like, now we're at a party, so we're assuming that they drank too much, they're gonna throw up. Jeg har det ikke så godt. But it could also be that they're sick. They're like, I'm in bed, it's not cool. Jeg har det ikke så godt. Kind of like that. Alright. Jeg har det ikke så godt. Jeg er for fuld til at køre. Jeg er for fuld til at køre. I'm too drunk to drive. For fuld. Too drunk. Jeg er for fuld til at køre. Lad os ringe efter en taxa. Lad os ringe efter en taxa. Let's call a cab or taxi. Lad os ringe efter en taxa. Even though when people are that drunk, they're not going to say much. They're just going to be like, oh, taxa. You'll see for yourself when you're in Denmark. All right. And then skip all the taxi because it's boring. And you say, jeg er lige kommet hjem. Jeg er lige kommet hjem. Jeg er lige kommet hjem. Like, I just got home. I just came home. This lige is like just. Like, it just happened. Jeg er lige kommet hjem. Exactly. Beautiful. Det var rigtig hyggeligt. Det var rigtig hyggeligt. It was really fun, cozy. Yeah, so as most of you already know, hyggeligt or hyggelig is cozy and not fun. But this is the thing with, you know, out in the world, nobody says cozy. You say, oh, it's fun. So, whatever. Right? This is just our version. You could also say, det var sjovt. S-J-O-V-T. Sjovt. It was fun. So, whatever floats your boat. Det var rigtig hyggeligt. Yeah. the last one. Det må vi gøre igen en anden gang. Det må vi gøre igen en anden gang. I'll have to do that again sometime. Eh? Yeah. It looks very long, but it's pretty simple. Det må vi gøre igen en anden gang. And in general, I encourage you to copy what you see. I also want you to make your own sentences. But if something is new to you, then copy what you see. And then later on, you can, you know, slowly start to replace words, because then you get a better structure. Why? Because you are taking it from native speakers, so you don't have to, you know, look in the blind or search in the blind. You already have a template that you can use. That's very, very good stuff. So, that was it. Well, those were the sentences. Before we wrap up, I have to say, a big thank you, a special thank you to all the members of this channel. As always, I really, really appreciate it. It means a lot to me that you are so serious about learning Danish and also that you want to support me and my work. So keep doing that. And if you yourself want to become a member, you can see that there's some links in the description and you can check that out. So yeah, then you can become cool and look like this. Yeah. But if you don't want to be a member, if you want to own the videos forever, then you can go to the website. And this time especially, I want to make you all aware that if you have the videos on the website, or if you're a member, or if you're a member on the YouTube channel, you also get access to all these cool PDF files. So like all these recent videos that I've done, you know, the ones that are based on slides, I have the PDFs, and you get access to them if you are a member of the channel, or if you got the videos on the website. And so recent videos, that means from October 2020, that's last year, and onwards. This also includes some upcoming videos. You have some Danish proverbs, listen and repeat 9, basic conjunctions, the correct Danish sentence. So actually you get to, you could say, cheat a little bit, and like you get to be ahead, so you can be prepared before the video comes. You can become familiar with the material. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty awesome. All right, let's see in the live chat what we got. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, we got Vlogfield saying hi, bror. Okay, bror, that's nice. We don't really say bror in Danish unless you're an actual brother, but cool. Det er ikke live. Oh, it's very live, trust me. Benum Hani Bilal says hello. Hello. Vlogfield again asks, nogensinde ever? Yeah. And 33AK33AK, cool name, says, hvad er juleøl? Juleøl, det er jo juleøl. It's Christmas beer, right? It actually already released in November. So yeah, check it out. I don't know if it's that amazing or special, but yeah, it's good. All beer is good. So, all right, that is it. Guys, thank you very much for watching, and have a good Christmas, or have a good December. I'll see you soon. Peace.